Welcome to the Spy Collection Digital Edition, where we are looking at spy artifacts that only exist in digital format. My name is Anastasios, and today we'll dive into a very recent cyber-espionage operation that, at the time of this publication, hasn't been attributed to any particular actor, although there are some prime suspects. First of all, this episode is based on this technical analysis that the Israeli cybersecurity firm Integer publicly released on December 19, 2025. One of Integer's primary services is scanning for malware, and, among others, this involves constantly looking into what people upload in the various virus checking websites, since in most cases, cyber operators also upload their malware there before an operation to verify that they will not be detected by any known antivirus software. Thus, by monitoring services like VirusTotal, cybersecurity experts regularly uncover new cyber espionage operations before they even launch. Apparently, in practice, this isn't that simple, since those samples that the spy agencies upload there, by definition, they are usually not detected as malicious. So, security researchers have to come up with clever ways to find the needle in the haystack. That said, in late October 2025, Integer detected such a file that was uploaded from two countries. First, from Ukraine, on October 26th, and a day later, on October 27th, it was uploaded from three different locations in Russia. This isn't hard evidence, as it's easy to spoof, but it might hint that the operator behind it was based in Ukraine and did that final test on October 26th before launching the operation that was targeting Russia, as we'll see in a moment. Here are the suspicious file names. The first means enemy's planned targets, and the second one, as per Integer's analysts, could be either do not release the enemy's planned targets or do not activate the enemy's scheduled targets. That makes it obvious that this wasn't targeting the average Russian citizen, but there is more to it. Before we go there though, it's worth noting that according to Integer analysts and other cybersecurity experts, all the digital forensic evidence collected matched with the TTPs of a previously observed cyber espionage actor, dubbed as PAPER WEREWOLF or GOFFEE. This actor has been active at least since 2022, exclusively targeting Russian entities with strong focus on military and government. Given the timing and target, we can speculate that this was either Ukraine or a joint group between Ukraine and some of its allies. However, this, for the time being, is only speculation. Alright, so that said, let's go back to the operation. That discovered file was sent to some Russian military officials. It's not known how it was delivered, whether it was email or any other means. But thanks to that software implant that Integer discovered, we know what was happening once the target opened it. As you might have noticed, the file extensions were XLL. That's Microsoft Excel files with extended functions. Various cyber operators have been using this file type lately, since it allows a wide range of methods to execute malicious code if a user opens it. In this case, though, without going into the technical details, the author of the spyware used a clever, not as common technique, to evade behavior-based antivirus detection. As we read, it was making the execution appear benign at first, and allowing the second stage payload to activate covertly after the sandbox times out or antivirus heuristics complete. The initial execution had a few more detection evasion techniques, but once done, it was covertly executing something that Integer dubbed as Echo Gather. Basically, that was the tactical recon capability of this software implant, collecting information about the target system and sending them to a pre-configured command and control server, or C2, via an encrypted channel. Specifically, the information it was gathering, it was things like IP addresses, operating system, architecture, system's name, username, domain, and so on. That was happening every approximately 5 to 6 minutes, with Echo Gather repeating this task. And as Integer discovered while reverse engineering it, it is designed to ignore SSL TLS certificate validation errors, allowing it to operate in environments with custom or misconfigured proxy and certificate settings. Now, the cyber spies that operated the C2 server could task the target systems, for example to copy a file, to execute a command, or anything else they wanted. Every 5 to 6 minutes that Echo Gather was sending this information to C2, it was also checking to see if there are any tasks for the software implant to execute. If there were any, it could download them, execute them, and send back the results to the C2. The fact that the communication is from the target to the C2 and not the other way around, a method called connect back, is because most organizations don't have as strict network security controls for outgoing traffic as they do for incoming, thus making it less likely to be detected. Knowing the hard-coded C2 server allowed Integer to pivot search from there to uncover more parts of the cyber-espionage operation. This was the hard-coded C2 server. And based on the dates they uncovered, we could construct a timeline that looks like this, based on the currently available information, of course. That already gives us an indication that there was months-long planning and preparation behind this. It wasn't something that was hastily put together. Using the same C2 details, Integer discovered more files that were uploaded on VirusTotal, referencing the same server. Two PowerShell scripts that once executed, they display some decoy, but covertly install the same Echo Gather software implant that we just talked about. Intel analysts of Integer also discovered that this decoy was AI-generated. They said, "The stamp in the lower right corner appears to be an AI-generated attempt at recreating Russia's national emblem, the double-headed eagle, but the result resembles a distorted or bird-like figure rather than the intended symbol." The text also includes several errors, and they explain all the findings in detail. But regardless, this decoy was pretending to be an invitation for a concert, specifically for high-ranking Russian military officers, that would take place on December 25th. And linked to this campaign, Integer also discovered this server. Here the cyber actors behind this operation used a different technique. The malicious file was a WinRAR archive, which was exploiting a recent vulnerability of WinRAR. This one. This vulnerability was completely unknown until July 2025, when ESET, a Slovakian cybersecurity firm, discovered it being exploited in the wild. Back then, ESET wrote about the actor behind it, that it was a Russia-aligned group that conducts both opportunistic campaigns against selected business verticals and targeted espionage operations. The group's focus has shifted to include espionage operations collecting intelligence in parallel with its more conventional cybercrime operations. This might sound odd at first, but cyber actors stealing capabilities from each other is more common than most think. And back to this operation, this WinRAR file was pretending to be a request from the Ministry of Industry and Trade, but it had spelling errors, and although it had slightly different execution flow, eventually it was still displaying a decoy document and covertly installing the same Echo Gather software implant. As Integer also noticed, those decoys, however, reveal who the targets might have been. Here specifically where we see some of the recipients of that fake letter that were four of the top military-industrial complex companies of Russia. The Almazanti, that develops anti-aircraft systems like the S-400 and the S-500, advanced missiles, radars and more. Then Schwabe, a major manufacturer of optoelectronic systems, optical instruments, laser and surveillance technologies. Followed by Opcrit, a holding company that manages and integrates dozens of electronics and radio engineering enterprises, including C4 ISR systems, electronic warfare and more. And lastly, VNI Center, a Russian state research and engineering institute, focusing on systems engineering, automation, digitalization, and lifecycle management for complex military programs. And with that we conclude this relatively recent, holiday-themed cyber-espionage operation that is still unknown who was behind it. Tell us what you think about it too. Hopefully this offers a small window into the intricate world around us, a world where the physical and digital realms intertwine, creating a vast and ever-shifting landscape. Here, spies are constantly pushing the boundaries, inventing clever ways to gain an edge, a powerful reminder that nothing is as it seems.